is just to give answer to some questions that people have raised concerning the issue of Prophet Isa, alayhi salatu wasalam. Where we supposed to be starting from in our tafsir of this year is Surah An-Nisa. And the answer that Imam wanted to raise has already been raised. And those that Imam wanted to give the answer to have directly or indirectly picked the answer. So inshallah, we've ended Surah Al-Imran last year. Even with the lockdown, we're able to end Al-Imran. We are starting our tafsir of this year from Surah An-Nisa. This surah is wholly dedicated to the women. For you to know how Allah regarded women in Islam, which means women have special space, special regard, special post in the sight of Allah. If you check the Quran from the beginning to the end, from Fatiha to Nas, you will never come across a Surah Al-Rijal. But for Allah, that has that special regard for women, dedicated a whole chapter to the women and made or named the chapter Surah An-Nisa. That is, women chapter. Which means all what Allah is discussing in this surah is all about women. It's all about women. Everything that needs to do with women is what Allah is discussing with in this surah. That's why Allah is starting. Barakallahu minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Allah is saying, Ya ayyuhan nas. Segregating it. What do I mean by Allah is not segregating it? Allah is not saying, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, because all of us that we call ourselves believers, we are not the only one that came from who we call women. And Allah is not saying, Ya ayyuhal kafirun, because even the non-believers were not the only one that women gave birth to. Either you are a believer or you are a non-believer. So far you are a human being, a woman gave birth to you. And that's why Allah is saying, Ya ayyuhan nas, O you mankind. Allah is saying, O you mankind. So far you are a human being. You have all what makes people to be calling you human being. I mean, you have all what I'm having. That makes people to be calling me human being is what is in you. You are a human being, and Allah is referring to you here. Allah is saying, O mankind, ittaqullaha. You know, he's generalizing it. And he's saying, ittaqullaha, fear Allah. Allah, your Lord, that created you from one single soul. What's this soul? Adam, alayhi salatu wa salam, is the single soul that Allah is referring to in this ayah. Allah is saying, fear ye Allah. Because if you are a man, you should believe that a woman gave birth to you. If you are a woman, you should believe that you came from the world, the rib side of a man. Two of us, we need each other, either we like it or not. No man will say in my own life, I don't have anything to do with women. And no woman will say in my own life, I don't have anything to do with what? With man. That is why the Prophet says in one of the traditions, no calibacy in Islam. What mean of calibacy? For one to say that me, I don't have anything to do with women, or me, I don't have anything to do with man in my life, We are interwoven, and that is how Allah created us. For Allah that created us from that single soul, who is who? Adam, alayhi salatu wasalam. He's now saying, one single soul is best known to Allah. Nobody can comprehend the wisdom. It is only Allah that knows the reason why. And for he alone that knows the reason why, he's saying, fear him in treating women nicely. Fear him in treating one another nicely. Don't maltreat women. Don't maltreat women. Don't usurp women. That's why Allah is starting by saying, Ittaqullah. Fear Allah. Even in marriage, the foundation of everything, as Malam should be telling you, is that marriage, the bedrock of marriage is what? Taqwa. Fear of Allah. Because anybody that has no any piety in him, Allah is not asking such a person to engage in any man or a woman. It must be with the what? With the piles of Allah. You must fear Allah, because that is the foundation of every relationship. Without fear of Allah, that relationship will never be called a relationship. It's as if we are building a what? A building without a pillar. The pillar of marriage is fear of Allah. Any marital affair that is what is consumed without the fear of Allah will never last. And that's why Allah is saying here, fear I Allah. Your wife that we are calling your what? Your second partner. Yes, she's your second partner. But believe me, you, as Allah is saying, two of you are from the same place. You are from the same source. You are from a single soul. And what's that single soul? Adam, alayhi salatu wasalam. If you know that all of you have the same source, you will never maltreat each other. A man will never be what? Maltreating his wife. And a wife will never be what? Cheating on her husband. Everything is what? Is with taqwa. Ittaqu rabbakum allazi khalaqakum min nafsin wahida. And he said, taking us back to our source. Because for some people that are late, they don't know what they are doing due to the way they claim to have been philosophers. And that philosophy has brainwashed them. When you ask them, most especially the atheists, when you ask them, who created you? He will say his own father and his own mother. Who created your father and your mother? He will say their own father and their own mother. Who created their own? That's how it will continue going. And Allah is now taking us back to our source. That either we like it or not, irrespective of our color, irrespective of our tribe, irrespective of our religion, irrespective of our family background, we are from the same soul. And from this single soul, whom we refer to as who? Adam. Allah created his own spouse, Hawa. It's a long story. We may not dwell into it in detail. Even scholars diverge concerning how Hawa was created from Adam. But generally, Hawa was created from the left rib of Adam. And that's why Allah called every woman a partner to her own husband. You are him, he is you. Because two of you are from the same source. And from that source, another source came up. Adam is from Allah with kun and fayakun. Why with that same kun, Hawa came from who? From Adam. We cannot say that maybe the way some people will be telling us that maybe Hawa, Adam gave birth to Hawa, which means he married his own daughter. Nothing like that in Islam. He never gave birth to Hawa. Allah that created Adam miraculously, that has never happened. And he has the absolute power to do everything that has never happened. He created Adam without a source. He has no father, no mother. It is with what? Ordinary kun. Allah created Adam. And created Isa in another dimension, having mother without father. Even if today people are misleading people by telling us that maybe so far is having mother without father, which means God is the father, for he has been born. Allah is more than having a child. He's more than that. And if you want to understand, dwell more on Surah Al-Ikhlas. That's not where we are going. Allah that did the first and have absolute power to do the second, miraculously did the same thing with Hawa. He created Hawa from the left rib of Adam miraculously. No father, no mother too. إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئاً أن يقول له. That is Allah for you. That is Allah for you. If you fail to understand Allah up to now, just ponder over the creation of Adam and Hawa. You will end it up in saying Allahu Akbar. Just ponder over their creation. You will know that Allah is mightier than anything that you can ever imagine. Allah is greater than any other thing that you can ever imagine. That's why he's saying, وَكَلَّكَ مِنِهَا زَوْجَهَا. It's a miracle. And the same miracle he implemented in creating Hawa from Adam again. Created Adam from nothing, because sand, clay that we are all seeing is nothing. And all of us, the way we are seated here, we are from the same nothing. All of us, we are product of sand. Forget about the way our parents copulated before we are what we are today. All of us, we are product of sand. Minha khalaqnakum wa fiha nu'idukum wa minha nukhrijukum taharatan ukhra. From the sand, Allah created you. To the sand, you'll be returned. And from the sand, you'll be resurrected at its appointed time. If we still have some people here that are still doubting or still arguing that me, I'm not product of sand, how will you, madam, call me a sand? Now, let me give you an assignment. When you get back home tonight, make sure that you look for this kind of a garment, very clean, if possible, very white. Take your bath. Make sure slippers is in your leg, from the bedroom down to your own bed. Don't allow your leg to even touch ground after taking your bath. Lay on your bed. If you wake up in the following day and you are not picking sand on your bed, which means you are not from sand. But if you are picking sand from your bed, you are the one that is shrinking. You are the one that is shrinking. We are from nothing before we become something. And from this something, we will all be back to nothing. That is Allah for you. And he's saying, this is for you to know that if any man is cheating on a woman, is not cheating on that woman, rather is cheating on himself. If any man is malfeiting a woman, is not malfeiting that woman, rather is malfeiting himself. Likewise, if a woman is cheating on a man, she is not cheating on that man, rather she's cheating on herself. If a woman is maltreating a man, she is not maltreating that man, rather she's maltreating herself. A few misunderstanding. ni nde pe ni iwa oko ojo ti yawo iwa yawo ojo koko ah e wa die dada e wa die dada they are not from the same source awon o be source kana ni ko si mo ko se mo lohun ba yawo ja tohun lohun wa lohun gbadun abi bi yawo mo ni ah o wa koko won ja ohun wa gbadun asiko ta nse mo nja yi lohun mo gbadun. We are interpreting Quran to ourselves. You are from the same source. You are one. Treat yourself as one. Don't let any sign of divisibility come into your midst. You are one. Min nafsin wahida. Wa kalaka minha zawjaha. Because you are one. Order. Ase mo nri oko mi to won ati yawo re ojo ra won se ya kan ti baba kina bi won le to si wopo nanu abi e mo ri ka mo si wa jora won bi mo mo oko ati yawo si won o mara won yi e fi han pe ni ohun ni fe hare to lohun lohun yo iyawo n kaluku fun latara re bo lo se ma wa fara ni fe hare tinu re si mo du ara re lo fara ni inda re bo lo se mo fi ya je fun hare tinu re o si mo dun ara re lo n fi ya je afeni ti ko ba muna doko lo won ni pada se wo wa basa minhuma rijalan kaseeran wan nisaa and from these two our source if you are following what we are saying our source remains Adam and Hawa. And from the two of them, Allah created many men and many women coming down. Atara awon mejeji na ni source ni gogo awon omo awon omo awon aromodomo awon aromo romodomo domo tin waye titi te kan wa ta waye won e so Yoruba e ma binu e ma ngbe mi e ma tap mi e ma kwa sebu. You see, which means indirectly again, marriage is source of children, but not like nowadays. That people have now gone extra mile, doing something in contrary with what Allah said. Emma ja lo be o wa basa minhuma and Allah is now repeating wa taqullah which means every ayah is talking about marriage or let me say marital affairs. Mostly is dwelling about marital affairs. For many people that will be thinking that maybe marriage is just something that I will just enter into dogmatically. No, you can't just dwell into marriage without knowing all the principles of marriage. This is what Allah is saying here. He started with fearing of Allah before you even embark on marriage. After saying all what he wanted to say, we are still treating the first ayah. Is still coming back to what taqullah. Fear Allah. Fear Allah. Fear Allah. Alladhi tasa'aluna bihi. Whom you are, we have two interpretations for this. Number one, whom you have always be asking of something from, fear him. Number two interpretation, alladhi tasa'aluna bihi wal arham bihi, whom you are always raising up, relying your affairs to fear him. Wal arham. Wal arham. That is family ties. Family ties. Everybody will now believe with me that yes. When we are talking of family ties, it started from marriage. Immediately when you get the girl from our own family, that family has become yours. And you are part of the family. Isn't it? immediately when you marry somebody from outside, you are part of the family. That woman that is coming to your own house, immediately when she steps her legs into your own house, she is part of your family. So you can see how family ties is being kept Islamically. Allah doesn't want us to break what we call family ties. And that's why he's what? Re-emphasizing on marriage. And he's emphasizing on taking care of women. Not every woman that we say they should get married, after getting married, that they enjoy the marriage. And likewise, not all men that we are saying they should get married, and after the marriage, they are enjoying the marriage. And that's why Allah is emphasizing on taqwa. It is taqwa that will make you to know how to deal with man. It is taqwa that will make you to know how to deal with women. Because whatever you are doing on your wife and whatever you are doing on your husband, Allah is coming to ask you one day. You will account for it. Either you hold each other tightly or you are going in a wrong way with one another. Allah will ask you. Well, Arhama, that family ties that the marriage has brought about, will you allow it to break through you? Allah is coming to ask you. And Allah is saying, وَآتُ الْيَتَامَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ. And make sure you are giving the orphans their wealth back completely. Give the orphans their wealth back completely. Allah may be talking in parable here, referring to the orphan. But scholars, most especially the Mufassirun, made us to understand that it is women that Allah is regarding as an orphan here. Because the person that you went to their family, you brought into your own house, abandoning her own father and her own mother, indirectly she has become an orphan. So make sure you act judiciously on her. وَآتُ الْيَتَامَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ. وَلَا تَتَبَدَّلُ الْخَبِيثَ بِالطَّيِّبِ. Don't cheat on her. Don't usurp her. Don't maltreat her. That is your woman. And likewise, whom we refer to as an orphan, who was kept under your custody, don't maltreat the orphan. Don't cheat on the orphan. Don't be sitting on the orphan's properties. That is, don't be mixing things upside down on him or her. The money that is meant for an orphan, don't mix it together with your own money. Some, these days, they are not even mixing it. They are even sitting on it totally. Hello, Yabi. There is no any other sin that is as great as this sin of eating the wealth of an orphan. And if you are interpreting it to be a woman that you are putting under your custody, there is no any other sin that is as great than the sin of you maltreating your woman. Esalani, innahu kana hubban kabira, wa in khiftum an la tuksitu fil yatama.
Indirectly,
lot of insult in what? In parable here. In just why you want to be? Aya, I told you, so I keep them and land looks to fill your tama. You know, in the course of the interpretation of the first ayah, I did the interpretation in the two ways. Those that called it the orphans, we interpreted it downward. And those that say, no, Allah is speaking in parable. It's not orphan. Because it didn't start with orphan. How will he enter orphan? They too are right. And to me, they are even more right. And this ayah that we are about to explain is what will tell you, what will make you to know that it is not orphan, it is your women. Allah is saying, from the bottom of your heart, and you know that you are not going to maintain justice on orphans. Orphan, who are the dancing? Can someone look at orphan? I want Yahoo Leno. I want Benelon only fast, yes, orphan. Turning out to a lot of Darren, Yahoo Bodo, Jemma, or more, look at anyone on Darren. Oh, Bodo Kia Jemma. Or more, look at the Cacolentio, Nia Lietio, Niba Balaye. I am not circumstances in man so dear more Ruka. But so I want to have in your one let your more Ruka Londawa. Irubosi let treat your more Ruka along that Obo will treat your one Yawo in Nule. Tobama, oh, let treat your one tack with Omo Ruka Yilawa Yawo in Nule. Eh? Why in Krypton and Latta to Tufli Yatama? If you know that you can never maintain what we call justice on those that we refer to as orphan under your custody, that means your wife, if you can't maintain justice on her, thank you. The meaning is that Obama Ben Yahoo Tofe Ole maintain ye Abe Tofe Fe. Oh, lay, God, you the boss, a moon, and do cobalon, chef. Then, thank you, Huma, Tobala Kumin and Nisa. Wife and Toba won't know, Berry. Wife and Toba won't. Cause it didn't be a law. Nothing is stopping you. If you know that, oh, my ye, oh, my toka, when he took part in investing, toss it near, or don't listen to water, in the ear, but more in our status. And I come on, shall I better? You may not be in our status. Oh, tell me again. I mean, what if I told my poor little girl? In the long window. But how come we're very nearby? I got two men there. Look, I got you. Like a move, a collar, or just yo ma demand the phone iPhone, and yo ma demand the phone Lexus car. You see, everything in Islam is even in category. I ma wara nimba waja, elumi walo for reven to wori uto. Yo waja nuri, yo ba ma sari kiri. Ikoja ye ni on weri kike. Olon ti fi kai tu si close. Tuwa ma pedi apa re o karu amele. O ma bo se ma wa fe a mo sa wa uti ena. Tori maintain ti o si ni je balejo ogun funjo alkiyama ai maye okunrin mi le aye lo nto pe ni inwura yin wo ma jenna ni wallahi o manani latara ya ore ai maye obirin mi si ni le aye to pe inwura re wo ma jenna ni wallahi o manani latara oko ti e na e fe nte ba mo pe ah sawawu mi lele qur'ani mi o la sin tu fuwa fakihu ma tabalakum minan nisa. Allah wa bi akini this ayah, most of our mothers, most of our women never like hearing it. Am I what you tori be in tolohun wi oto ni sin tawon afa ntu fun won e gbo mi e awon tan tu fun ni o je wu won gbo. I will be that even. When Allah took it yatama te ba mo pe eni ti oju re ganu okunrin o le fe tori ma ti ara yin eni to ju re ganu obirin o le fe ma ti ara yin wa fe de de sa wa wu ti e olorun wa ni masna to ba mo pe ni agbara ti e if you know that you are able and capable of scoring to score If you know that you are able and capable of scoring three, score. If you know that you are capable of scoring four, score. What's the meaning? What's the meaning? Aditulola unsoro, only two ma. Ituma re, let me expatiate it for our understanding. Hello me. Ko ni agbara ati po iyawo kankan ko po yanju ohun owo re o to ojukokoro wa mo lo re leri aja kini ni o wa ja mo leri olohun to bere pelu masna tele na ko olohun gan masna lo fi bere it has wisdom olohun ni n to be fa yo nbe ni in ta agbara re o ba ka lo fi bi ko se meji agbara re ba ka ni o le fe yawo meji bo se meta ni o le fe yawo meta bo se merin ni o le fe yawo meni wa in khiftum alla ta'dilu But if you know that emi o kai emi o ro pe mo ni agbara Everybody knows his pocket now you know your source of income you know what you are capable of doing if you know that emi o lagbara o is ni kola ko lowo lowo because everything in islam as one as lori is not by money o le lowo lowo ko mo ni la kai da mi tole o le lowo lowo ko fi le fe yawo meji ko fi le fe meta ko fi le fe merin abo to ba ni la kai da mi tole nko olohun o bi o fe you may be rich you may be having everything that you need is in your house to even marry more than four self if possible but you lack what we call wisdom of maintaining the house olohun obi o olohun obi o lo fini wa in kiftum allah ta'dilu fawa koda elomi ko ni la kai tan fin to yawo kankan funa re e ma ti ja so meji e ma ti ja so meta iyawo yo kala se ga elomi o ni la kai bi o se to yo se mo pe elomi wa ba won da si afia si won ni ko mo be won le se se tu mata amikebli laarin won ati yawo won e ri pe olohun to gbe lati be ni o ni n to fe fa yo won mo pe ni kini kan ni keyan kokko generalize nkan before you now segregate it e yes ko le specialize kan o to wa para wa generalize e olohun generalize e nbi bayi ni o para wa specialize e o generalize e pelu pe ni if you know that you are able and capable and you have the wisdom and sense and everything that it takes for you to marry two marry or three marry or four marry but if you know that you lack all this do lori oyo kan re o ko mo fi owo ara re sira re enikan o bi onse for wahida stick on your wine min Allah hadisa wa ma ahsanu min Allah qila ta lo tun moro so tolo mo ta lo moro gbe kale bi olohun obo funa re who is more eloquent in delivering speech than Allah the speech himself look at what Allah is saying here aw ma malakati agbara re akokolo re koda iyawo kankan o gbe ko ni opolo ko si ni agbara te yen tele fi fe yawo kan awa bi ni ma malakati aymanukum in ta pare ba ka what is in your possession stick on that ni mo fi so oro agatule kan bi pe if you know that this one she doesn't have anything she's a typical villager kò sí tó kan pẹ̀lú shawama kò sí tó kan pẹ̀lú pizza
ohun ti e mo tin je be ke po gbe siwaju le ke mo je le je tin je gbe ni iru e baun ki le wa fun boya bi gari eko iru awon baun so mo ke oni na lowo pupo itumo ma mo la kan ti aimanu kun ti qur'ani nwinu stick on the one that you know that your hand can what maintain. Zalika adna Allah ta'ulu. Olorun ni eleyi gangan ni nkan to da. Te fi ni sese gbe. Elomi ko lagbara yawo meji, o si lo o kan to ni tele won gbadun ara won o. Amo la pe o fe se bi lagbaja, ko si to bi lagbaja. O pada wa gun keke koja ewe o regi o se kini o gugunre koja ewe abun oro qur'an wo lawon yan tele ife nu de qur'an to so o so so ra hatan gugu agbo ya ba agbo yin bolon se sonu o fi close si amelo mi tori oju kokoro re emi na fe se bi lagbaja o si pada wa te ju lagbaja hun lo tori lagbaja to fe fa fara we yi ohun lagbara re ni. And let me tell you quickly, marrying 2, 3, and 4, the way Allah say, it's a means of alleviating poverty away from the society, number one. Number two, it's a means of making our Muslim women that you are out of wedlock be engaged with somebody. Number three, it's a closing door to the means of committing zina. Teba wo lo de oni to be frank with each other. Ko sibiti le ase wo si te ba te mo bo mi e wo Abuja wa yi. Ko sibiti le ase wo si. Ko sibita mo ko mo si. Gbogun won po lo jara. Te ba wa wo alhamdulillah. In le fi gbogbe do se 100%, but I can say outrightly 99.9% are non-Muslims. Why? Because I will abide by anti Islamic preaching. They are not abiding by the Islamic preaching. In too far, no. I abide by Islamic preaching. Ati magbao ah oma iti balaga kiloku oti leko oti nise oti ni gogwe ili okoloya. Ko ba le mashi se zalika Allah ta'ala. And the same thing, Zalika Adne Allah Ta'ulu, tori okunrin na ko na ma ba won tete follow me test lo un lohun se up till today is still testing, is sampling them. Up till today is sampling them. O ti mu kankan o ko si kankan le re e kan sample won ko ba bele yi o tun bele yi o tun gan ile yi o tun gele yi in to un fi le aye re so ko ba le ma sele l'Olorun fi ni e engage. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in one of traditions say, ya ma'ashara shabbab man istata'a minkum al-ba'a falyatazawwaj fa innaha adaddu lil basar wa asanu lil farj faman lam yastati fa alayhi bisiyam fa inna lahu biha wija'an. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anabi ni ya ma'ashara shabbab, I am calling upon you youths, a male and a female. Man istata'a minkum al-ba'a, anyone among you, either you are a male or you are a female, so far you are a youth, if you know you have attained what we call puberty stage, look for a wife or look for a husband. Engage yourself. Don't let people be sampling you and don't be sampling people. Because marriage will make you to be lowering your gaze. Say you rent your near will and you ready for my wood. Hey, and you near will and go my war, honey. Be a jatting way, won't you? I meant to buy near only. Oh, do you to put up what you told you? Tell it. O ju lo si ma ro tara pe kini o ni nkan ta npe ni coolant ninu le kini coolant ta so yi iyawo ni agadu lele basor o ma muore oju re nle o ni ma wo hara hara o kan ni ma wo gugu awon mata nlo o ni ma wo won tori be kini ki lo fe wa lara ni ti o si ni nto gbesile agadu lele basor elekeji wa asanul farj and it will make you to be covering your chastity. What do I mean by chastity? Your private part. You will not be misusing your private part as a man or as a woman. By committing fornication, you will not be doing that. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَسْتَتِي. And if you know that I've attained the puberty stage, but up to now, I'm not yet blessed, even if in Islam, marriage is not because you don't have money. Prophet Muhammad conducted a lot of marriages without the husband having any dime. And after the marriage, Allah started blessing the man. Let me tell you this one quickly. Marriage, if you don't know, is a source of blessing. If you see anybody in your family or around you that is suffering, lacking many things, iyanje ounganje iya. Temejo jora won. Iyanje ounganje ounganje iya. E wa pe on to pe se nfo lona owo to ba ni fun mi sabe ke emi lo ro pe boya ofe phone ni na ka li kan ni abo fe mo lo odo babalawo kan to bo hun se yahoo plus o ron pe ni lo fe yahoo sabe e yo order na pe mo ni irise o to ni lo fe yahoo be ni yo ri se Quran confirmed it, even the Prophet sallam confirmed it. In yakunu fuqara yughnihumullahu min fadlihi. Even if you are poor before, just make sure you engage yourself. Marry somebody with love, not what? Not by marriage sake. Not because they say I should marry and marry. No. Sincerely marry, and you will see that Allah will open the channels for you. Oh, Siri. Oh, Guantanamo, we need. Yes, Allah, Allah, Allah. And then il temiso gina fin nikah te ba ren to ti osi mu daru ti o ri ba ti se ko rona gbegba e so foro nton pe ni lowo ona mo lowo na bayo latara kini latara pe ko lo se yawo il temiso gina e ma wa oro yin si bi kini fin nikah latara pe a n se yawo ke o so pe fi siwaji o ko so pe bi siwaji o telemi o pe na emi kan ti mo ti ni yawo le ti ri se di sin be ni wo bo lo se ni ti e bo lo se ni se gba window wole ni abe gba oju ile wole ai maye oko to doko yawo lo n te pe window na gba wole iru e be ni sin hadith yi yo be ma se ba kan ba kan le re pe emi fe yawo na mi si ti ri se o gba oju ile wole window lo gba wole eh iwo gbojule wole wo ko wo boya olohun o si ona fun in terms of gina fin nikai. Seek for your what? For your means, livelihood, richness in engaging yourself in marriage, even if you are poor before. Just because you marry, Allah will use that to open the channels of anything. That is Allah for you. So inshallah, here is where we are going to draw the curtain concerning marriage and the source of marriage, concerning marriage and its source. So inshallah, here we are going to draw the curtain. May Almighty Allah spare our lives to tomorrow and beyond. May Almighty Allah let all what we listen to be of a great benefit for us in our lives and in our graves and in thereafter. بياك لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العظيم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون.